As we've seen, Mill's methods can be used to establish that a causal relationship exists between two events or states of affairs. When we use the methods for this purpose, we say that we're using the standard use of them. However, Mill's methods also have a negative use. The negative use of Mill's methods show that a causal relationship does not exist. If you're able to recognize the standard use of the methods, then identifying the negative use is relatively straightforward. So let's look at some examples. You should be able to recognize fairly easily that this is an example of the use of agreement. We have an independent variable, the waffle iron being on, that's present in all three cases. However, notice what's happening over on the right-hand side of the diagram. In the first two cases, the breaker is tripping. However, in case three, the breaker did not trip. What this shows us is that the waffle iron being on is not sufficient to trip the circuit breaker. So we're using the method of agreement negatively to show that there's not a causal relationship between the two events. The method of difference also has a negative use. In this fairly simple example, we have two cases. In case one, salt, flour, egg, and water are being used to make a cake, and the cake tastes terrible. In case two, flour, egg, and water are being used, and the cake still tastes terrible. Because the independent variable that we're testing, that is salt, is present in case one, but not in case two, this is the method of difference. However, because there's no change in the effect, that means that we're using the method negatively to show that the presence of salt is not necessary to cause the cake to taste terrible. The joint method of agreement and difference also has a negative application. Predictably, the negative application of this method is simply either the negative use of agreement or the negative use of difference. So in this example, we actually see both in use. In the upper part of the diagram, we have two individuals, Steve and Mary, who ate very different things, except for sesame chicken. That looks like method of agreement. However, as we see over on the right-hand side, Steve did not become ill, but Mary did. So that's the negative use of agreement. In addition, we have two individuals, Mary and Alice, who had two things in common, moo shoo pork and egg drop soup, but not sesame chicken, and yet they both became ill. This again suggests that sesame chicken was not the cause of their illness. So that's the negative use of difference. The method of concomitant variations also has a negative use. Turning to an example from the previous lecture, here we have altitude increasing, but the feeling of sleepiness is not. So there is not a concomitant relationship between increased altitude and an increased feeling of sleepiness. So this then shows the negative use of the method. Finally, remember that the method of residues does not have a negative use. Method of residues is only used when we've already established that there's a causal relationship between a number of independent variables and an effect, and we're using the method simply to establish how much of a contribution one of those variables makes.